Hello everybody and welcome to Zalmoxis tries to break out. Oh, no, just kidding. Jurassic World, the game. And it has been a while. And of course, I thought I would, you know, I'd open up the game and I would say, you know, I was going to record today, but let's see if there's anything worth it. And it's like, oh, Code Red, bah. So, well, I guess welcome to another episode. I have a frog in my throat, as always, seems to be. It's that time of year. The frogs leave their ponds and jump in people's throats. It's horrible. Oh my god. Anyway, how are you doing today? I hope you're having a lovely day today. And I'm going to try and not fail too much when it comes to this. Ooh, we're doing good. I'm going to say it's 450, isn't it? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Am I going to get 450? Ooh, I don't know. Ah, balls. Well, there goes me DNA. Could have got, but didn't. Now, if you give me a second, I'm just going to eject this frog from me throat.
Is that better? That's better.
I'm back. Yay. So, what are we doing today? Well, a lot of things have happened, actually. I think I've got enough for another Indoraptor, so I get an Indoraptor, but the biggest update to the game so far is the addition of another aquatic hybrid, the Dacoderma, which is Dacosaurus and Phosphoderma? Popcorn, I think is the one. Hello. So, I put it in here and it's still not done. Oh, fantastic. Well, I'm kind of glad that it's been 2 days and I've saved myself 160 bucks. So far, but I'm probably going to end up spending that anyway in order to get, oh, no, more. Going to spend more. So that was 4 attempts, 2 for free, 2 cost, and now it's 5 attempts, 3 cost. Well, that's a lot of books that disappeared, so we're going to feed the thing. We might as well watch it for the final time at level 40, because I can't imagine myself getting it level 40 again. Ooh! Nom, nom. Ooh! Never had a level 40, and here it is! Absolutely useless, except for possibly a tournament. But we're gonna fuse it to make Daco Tobaccosaurus. Oh god, he's got the eye. He's got the look. Ooh. And here it is. I don't really know if it's worth it. But we gotta finish that quota for getting all of the creatures. So, oh, it's a cavern. Has it got a new animation? Ooh, let's have a look. I feel like it. It kind of does, but it doesn't. Oh, that's interesting. If any of you guys don't know, this has the animation of it's a reef. I think it's a reef. It's Trinacarium. It must have the animation set of a reef like Trinacarium, but it's a cave. So that's really weird, and it's slightly different, because it doesn't do multiple spins around, and I'm pretty sure that final bit there is completely different. So let's have that is as close as we can get, unfortunately, unless he comes towards the camera. So he's got a weird tail. It's almost like a morning star, a bit, and if you don't know what a morning star is, it's a weapon. So we're going to evolve it, but we need to get another one. So it is 28,000. So we do have the Leptostega, which is a little bit less. But this guy has over 100 extra attack and less than 100 health. I mean, in this game, it's better to have more attack. I find very rare instances where I survive with that extra 100 health. And I'm like, oh, thank God I have 100 health. Because unless they're going for one attack, you don't know how much they're exactly gonna do. So if they, you know, because if they do 2 hits, you're like, you can kind of estimate how much it's gonna do. If you really want, you can go on like MetaHub or something and type in its exact amount of damage, but that's gonna take more time than you just putting in one block and exiting the game, because that's pretty much what this game has evolved into. It's just, yeah, as long as you put in one block, if I die, well, there you go. So we'll get it to level 20 and see. So it's going to have like 2,000 health and 1,400 attack, is it? 1,400 and at level 714 health and 521, yes! Oh, and get it up to 688 attack and 944 health. Ooh, I like the colors. I have actually already faced this thing in a battle tournament thing, I think it was. So that was one. We need to buy seven more. So that's 7 times 2. That's 1,000 or 10 or 14,000 bucks that's going to cost me. Because 200 to speed up. Yeah, that's 14,000 bucks it's going to cost me. So I'm not going to do that. But what I will do, just to save money and time, because I don't even know if we have a Leptostegra level 4. No, we've only got one. So that's interesting. I think getting these guys... Oops! Did I buy the other one? Yeah, I think I did. So Ducko, yes you. So that's two. That takes that up to level 30. That's a day. You know what it is? I'll speed it up. I'll speed up this guy just so we can fill it up with another two of these. Oh! Oh, never mind. Oh, balls. It's already level 30. God damn it. Well, might as well feed it now. There you go. And I might as well buy another one, actually. So there we go. There's another one. So we can get another level 20, and then we'll have a level 30 of that. So we've also, I think since I last recorded a video on this, there has been a dodo boss. I'm trying to think what else has kind of been and went. Ooh, anything good here? Maybe. Ooh, yes! 30 million food, get rid of that! And then I can go on this and get almost a million! Because I've been kind of maxed out for a while. I wonder! Because I wonder if trading food for bucks, if you get more, and if it's worth it. Because I have been maxed out. 2,000 bucks for a microbosaurus you can jog on. So let's collect a little bit of that. And let's see. Actually, hold on. Oh, no. Damn. I just realized. I've got to get another one of these, haven't I? I've got to buy another. 50 to activate. And 6 days. Actually, you know what? That's not too bad. Okay, so we've got another interrupter. We're pretty close to a Sarcosuchus. We need 100 more. So, I mean, say we're close. We're kind of not really. A Troodon. Whoa, we can win a Troodon pack for 500 DNA. Hell yeah. All of it. So, oh, we didn't win the creature. I think we've won 1,000 DNA. 1,000 DNA and 1,800 DNA. And a Protostega. Is it worth it? You know what? Just to at least get me to this and to maybe win something on the gold prize wheel, I'll put it in. I'm kind of having... Oh! Yes! Oh, what we get? Ooh, did we get Uteranus? Oh, we did! Awesome! Well, that was well worth it. And I basically just got all the VIP points I spent back again. Oh, that was well worth it. Oh, and I got these as well, the claim. I think, yeah, these are food, actually. And I do need it, because I didn't really care for it a second ago when I did it. 200 bucks for DNA? I don't think so. And really the best one resets in 5 days, so I'll wait until maybe something better comes. You've got some good prizes in here, though. I mean, look at them. Your Diamond Ferocity, you're going to get a VIP creature. And stuff like Plotosaurus, in fact, all of them. I'm pretty sure all of those are really good. So, anyway, on to the battles! Let's see what we got. So we've got a Fight for Fusion, which gives us... Monolophosaurus. I'd rather have the mono. We've also got Rarity Rumble. We've got... Oh, VIP exclusive event! Ooh, might as well finish this off. To put into Jungasauruses. And I'll put in Sarazenosaurus. I could be wrong. Actually, I'm probably very wrong. But I think that the Super DNA isn't too hard to win. It probably is really hard. So I got to put in a block here just in case. Because I didn't see Spinoraptor's attack. Oh, God, that would have been over 7,000 damage in two hits. And As you can see, when dealing with stuff like this, having 100 health doesn't really make much of a difference. But having 100 attack does, because if you go for 8, that's like an extra, what, maybe 1,000 damage, if that? But maybe even more, just for having 100. So 1-2 doesn't kill him! Ah, that's annoying. Okay, so he did have one block. I went for one too many. I'm definitely gonna have to exit out. Oh, there we go. We're just gonna have to exit out. Oh, have I played this much? Not too much. I keep on forgetting, actually. I'm taking like a way more relaxed approach to making videos, or maybe not. I'm not rushing myself as I used to. Like, every day I would be like, okay, let's cover that. It's kind of a bit crazy at the moment just because Tabs has released. There's been a new update in Fish Feed and Grow. There's new updates coming to loads of app games like this one, like Jurassic World Alive, like Hungry Shark and all that jazz. And Jurassic World Evolution as well is starting to get updates, or like updates are coming for it. So before this month, there was nothing really to do. So I was just taking a more relaxed approach, enjoying life, learning to play piano, and learning to loads of other things, and just sort of enjoying it, relaxing, enjoying the one life you get. And I don't want to spend the majority of it in front of a screen, because either way, I'm probably going to end up doing that anyway. But at least I'll try to not do it as much. Ooh, 2 hits. Ooh, it's got 14,000 health. Ooh. Oh, God. Oh, yes. Ooh, that's quite a lot of health. Forgot Rajasthaga's not one of the best. It's a legendary hybrid, though. It just has such pitiful attack and health. It's in the same leagues as Metrophodon, yet it doesn't even have half the attack. It has like a third of the attack and about the same health. It's ridiculous. Like, they might be a step above. I'm not sure, because they are tournament creatures on there. They're tournament creature hybrids, whereas these are just like regular hybrids. But still, I don't know if there's any extra glisten that they have. I'm not sure. I'll have to double check. Oh my god, it takes 4 to kill him. Oh god. Gonna have to exit out and make sure if I am gonna use that many attacks, it's going to kill him. Oh no. You see, the reason why you do this is because every day you have like at least 3 events to do, and your best creatures, because you need to use them, because you see what I'm facing, take at least a couple of days to recharge, if that. So you kind of have to do this glitch. He's definitely killed me. No, Rajasthaka. I remember when you were leaked by an ex-employee that put all their work online. And I actually made a video showcasing it, but then I took the video down because I thought, that's in bad taste. And then I think other people posted the video. Other people were like, look! And they put it in the thumbnail as well. I was like, I edited it out, but I may have kept it in the thumbnail, but it was like, I deliberately silhouetted it or something. I didn't show what it was. I was like, oh, there's something coming. But other people were just like, bam, thumbnail, there it is. here we go. Let's talk about YouTube, shall we? Oh, I love it. Drama, it's amazing. I've been in here for a while. Oh god, ooh, another reserve, there we go. I thought I'd already set it up. I've seen a lot of people, and I've seen a lot of different ways to make content, oh god. And there seems to be this thing when it comes to app games, or people that cover app games, they are, how should I say it? They try to put in as less, or as, what can you say, as least? Yeah, as minimum effort as it takes. Like, they will just either have no commentary, or it will, well, yeah, basically. It'll just be like, no commentary, very few edits and whatnot. And to be fair, it depends on what kind of content you're making, because if you know, the stuff that I've made, you know, I barely do as much editing as I do on this video as I would with tabs or something else. Just because, I mean, there's not really much I can edit out here without, you know, you guys losing out. Whereas with other games, there's a lot of grinding, there's a lot of, like, funny moments that happen. Whereas with this, you're seeing the same battle kind of going on. I could zoom in on Packy Ceratops right now and go, "Whoa!" But it would make literally no difference to, you know, I mean, I guess it would. But then again, it depends. but yeah, it does seem to be that people that cover app games just try... It's like, make a quick buck. That's what it is. It's like, I want to make as much money with as least... I can't understand the English phrase. as minimum effort in as possible. That's basically how it seems to go. And that's me observing and... just seeing it. Oh, is it gonna have 1-2 block? Oh, it does! Oh, that would have killed me! Oh, I don't know. That was 4 block, wasn't it? Oh, no. Please tell me you can't kill me in one hit. Please don't tell me. Oh, he definitely can. 1, 2, 3, 4. Do I go for one extra? Do I go for one extra just to be safe? Ah. Oh. No. No, I'm not going to. Okay, come on. Please don't have 5. Please don't have 5. Ah, you bugger you! He's gonna go for 5. And they always go for 5. Oh, you see? Oh, my God. Ooh. Duh. Jesus. God, I knew that was gonna happen. I knew that was gonna happen. Oh, you see? Now I've got to... Well, I may as well... And the thing is, Indoraptor there. Indoraptor... has like double the attack, so it's gonna make this so much easier. I'm gonna exit out half as many times because he kills this thing in 3 instead of like 6 hits. But just to be safe, I'm gonna have to do that, otherwise there's no way I can kill him without dying. But yeah, it does seem to be like people that cover them, they hack the games, which means that it takes no effort to make the content that people want to see, which is like the newest thing released that's maxed up and all upgrades and stuff. And that's basically what videos do well for app games. It's like, oh, I've got all the currency, here's everything unlocked, boom, done. Or at least it used to. Like I said, the modern YouTube, it's very strange. There used to be in 2015, 2016, there was a way to almost guarantee views. And you would stumble upon... There was multiple ways. And you would stumble upon it with a certain video that did well. And all you had to do was just find out what in that video triggered the audience to engage or YouTube's algorithm to promote it. And I would love to say that it's the effort you put in the video that makes it do well. And nowadays YouTube... that is 100% the case, which is why you see a lot of these channels like Arcade Go, Play Cow, I think. I remember those guys, Gaming Ninja and stuff, which are all channels that cover app games. I think, I'm not too sure, but their views have tanked dramatically since 2015-16. Like, back in those days, they were getting, like, 20 million, 30 million, 40 million views a month. Crazy, absolutely ludicrous numbers. And the reason as to how that success, the secret, was they just spammed out videos. No effort put into it. And they would find a thumbnail that did well. And then they would just copy and paste that thumbnail numerous times and then just change the hue and saturation. That was basically it. And I don't know if they still do it. But it worked for them because for the people behind those channels, it was just money. They didn't care about making good content. They didn't care about engaging with the audience. All they did was, they probably hired people just to play the games, to be honest. It's probably like a whole business behind it. Whereas now, those channels make like a tenth views of what they used to. It's kind of scary. But they're still doing the same thing. That's the thing. They haven't changed because they don't want to, because they don't care. They make the money still, so why not? I don't even know what got onto that, but hey, there we go. There's a little insider's look at someone, or with somebody who's sort of been in this industry for a while. And oh, there we go. Yep, there it is. There's the incredible hard one. Let's do this one. This is a nicer one. I like this one. So let's put in a very easy one, and then let's put in the Diplo suit, just the newest Diplo suit, as I might add. It's kind of like disheartening in a way. Because it's like people just don't care. And it's, in a way, you know, you could put in loads, or back then, you could put in loads of time and effort into something. But because, you know, you're not spamming out content, or you're not doing the very clickbaity thumbnails, you're not going to get views. You're not going to, you know. And but so it's kind of good that YouTube has changed, but at the same time, now I have no idea if a video I create is, oh god, I have to exit out that. I would die. Now, I have no idea whether a video is going to do well or not. And the only way I can kind of hope that it's going to do well is if I myself enjoy it, which is always, like, the reason why I make a video, is because I know that I want to do it. And if I put effort in it, there's no way now. There's no way. For about 3 years, and I'm saying this now because it was sort of like my Pandora's secret box of, like, this is how you get views. it was like 90% of views came because of a thumbnail. 100%. That was the only reason, and that's what me analyzing these channels that spammed out content, because the content was utter garbage. It was horrendous. There was no effort. It was just gameplay, and that's it. And even in some cases, gameplay that didn't even relate to the thumbnail, but it had millions of views. So that taught me that you need a thumbnail. If you don't have a thumbnail, you ain't getting views. That's how it goes. So with that in mind, I, of course, just tried to put more effort into the thumbnails, and it worked. It really did. And you know me, guys. I put effort into my stuff. I say. But, you know, like, I don't want to half-ass something, especially if I know that you guys want to see it, and I don't want to let you down, in a way, because when I'm editing, like, that's why I've edited my videos for so long, because I know, like, kind of what memes are relevant and what's going on right now with the community, or at least I try. I hold my hands up, guys. I won't say I'm spot on all the time. In fact, actually, I see loads of comments that are like, Beaver's bringing back a dead meme. What? I can't help it. I come across it a bit too late. Oh, we're gonna do it! We're gonna do it! Yes! I think, probably, I'll try! I'm gonna go for that, because I don't think that level 30 flyer can kill me in one hit. Ooh, he's close! He's close! But not close enough. Oh, even better! In fact, I can go for one reserve and two block and make sure I survive. Yeah. And one game I want to play Jurassic World Evolution. I really do. There's just not enough content there for me. Like, there's literally no difference from me playing it now, as of time of recording, as there was when I first opened the game. There's literally no difference, apart from some more dinosaurs and probably some bug fixes. And it sucks because I really want to play it. I really do. Oh god. You didn't see anything. He's gonna switch, isn't he? Oh god. He has to go for two to kill me. Aha! Shock it, loser! I'm going to bring in my own Carnoraptor. And you have two blocks. So there we go, and we are done. Only wait for one. Okay, not bad, because then he's going to switch out his Pachyceratops anyway. because then he's going to have four. Oh, no. Oh, it goes for five. Oh, he got us. Oh, no. Oh, I didn't see that. Oh, I might have lost. I might have lost. I've lost. I've lost. I cannot believe that. I cannot believe I've lost. Yep. 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 There we go. There we go. There we go. And this is another reason why a lot of people just go, sod it, I can't be bothered, and just hack the game and just put a million resources in. And I don't blame them, for gonna be honest. It's like, sod it. 82 bucks. There you can. Okay, boom. I say that. Yet. Yeah, go on. Yeah, that's good. That's good. Okay, so. Oh, wait, no, it's not. No, it's not. Okay, I'm gonna go for one reserve. Oh, I'll be surprised if I survive this one. I've spent 82 bucks and I might lose right off the bat. Right, I wanna keep Diplosuchus alive. Please go for two block. Oh. Ooh, ooh. He has to go for three to kill me. Ah! Yeah! Okay, that's fine. I'm gonna go for one block. Four reserves here. Ooh. I mean, that's the thing with this game. It's not a case of having really good creatures, per se. It's just, I mean, it used to be. And then about a year ago, or maybe even more now, this glitch was discovered, which means that the bot, if you exit and it's your turn, or sorry, their turn, they think you've got no blocks. So they just try and attack you for the minimum amount to kill you. And if you've got one block, you'll always survive as long as it's not your last creature. And the game is just kind of transformed into this, well, you know, you have so many events to do and you don't want to lose any of your dinosaurs, because if you use all of them, then you're going to have to buy them back for the next event that'll happen probably the next day. So you just end up putting in really rubbish creatures and then a good one in the middle. And that assures you win the match because you can do this glitch. It's so weird because that's all this game is. If you think about it, that's every battle. It doesn't matter what creatures you come up against. You put in two really weak creatures in the start and the last slot, and you put a really good creature in the middle. And every time you attack, you make sure that you have at least one block so that you don't die and you don't lose your best creature. That's it. Oh my god, mind blown. My whole life has been a lot. And I would probably survive that. I'd probably win that one because I've got the other hybrid there. Well, there you go. Exit it out anyway. Wow, this has been a rad story time. Always good story times. Maybe I'll share a personal story next time. You'll have to tune in and find out. And that should take the victory. There he goes. Look at him. Look at him, cutie. He's all free with his super DNA. And he's very good. Now. I mean, for a rare, it's kind of OP. At level 10, it's like, oh, Nundasuchus. Nice. Actually, I don't have that level 40, I don't think. Or if I do, I have another level 20. I don't even remember. Do I have a level 40? Do I? Hold on. Hybrids. No, I only have a level. Oh, it's in storage. Well, never mind. Well, I'm going to leave it here, guys. It's just so we don't clock over to the 30-minute mark. We get it just before we do. But if you enjoyed it, leave a like. And until next time, I'll see you, maybe with a personal story, in the next video. Bye-bye.